Hi students, today's experiment is characteristics of J-FET. The experiment, aim of the experiment is to study drain characteristics and transfer characteristics and to find the transconduction drain resistance and amplification factor. Required components are J-FET. J-FET resistor, this is regulator power supply and multimeter, ammeter, voltmeter and breadboard. Okay, here this is J-FET, junction field effect transistor. Here three terminals will be there. For the J-FET, we have four terminals. Actually, we required only three terminals, but here four terminals will be there. That is source, drain, gate, and substrate. We don't require substrate, so you have to folding this one. From here, one notch will be there. Here, one notch will be there. From the notch, clockwise direction, source, drain, gate. Last one is substrate. We don't require here now, so we have already folded this one. Okay? And we required, this is the circuit diagram. This is the circuit diagram. This for here BFW11. The FET name is BFW11. So source, gate, drain. Okay. And two resistors we required, 100K and 1K. And two voltmeters for the purpose of VGS input voltage and output voltage VDS purpose. And one ammeter for ID purpose, measuring the ID, output current. Okay, the connections are regulator power supply. For input side, we have to VGG and output side, we have required second channel is VDD. Okay, for VGG supply, negative is connected to the gate terminal and positive is connected to the supply or grounded or source. And output side, VDD is connected to the drain and negative is connected to the grounded source. Okay, here you require our input and output side two resistors for current limiting purpose. Okay, so you have to connect as per the circuit diagram on breadboard. I have already connected here gate, drain, source. This left side is input side and output, right side is output side. The gate side, this is gate to source side, this is drain to source side. Okay, from gate to source you require VGS. This multimeter is used for voltmeter purpose, VGS purpose. Here this one is VGS, here ID, output side. Okay, this is ID purpose and measuring the ID, and this is for output voltage, drain to source voltage, VDS purpose. Okay, next, let's start the DRPS. For the transfer characteristics, we require VDS, VGG, VGS and ID. The expected graph will be here. Expected graph of transfer characteristics, this is 0, VGS equal to 0, you will get maximum. If you're decreasing, VGS means minus 1, minus 0.5, minus 1, minus 1.5, the current will be, ID will be decreases. Okay. Next, let's do the practical. For VGS equal to, for transfer characteristics, we have to, output voltage will be constant, that is, we have to fix either 1 volts or 2 volts, 3 volts as per your requirement. Okay, now I am fixing the VDS equal to 1 volt. Okay, by varying VDD, we have to fix the VDS, that is, VDS voltage, output voltage, and next, we have to increase VGG and we have to measure the values of VGS and ID. Okay? First, I am fixing the output voltage VDS by using VDD, that is 1 volt. I am fixing the VDD equal to 1 volt. Here VDS equal to 1 volt. So VDS equal to 1 volt, at 0 volt VGG, supply voltage VGG for in transfer characteristics, VGG 0, VGS also 0, at ID will be 186 microamps. At VGS equal to 0, you will get maximum current is 186 microamps here for VDS equal to 1 volt. Already we have shown the expected graph here. At VGS equal to 0, I am getting ID is maximum current. Okay, Next, VGS equal to minus 0.5. VGS equal to 0.5. I am getting VGS is 0.46 and current is 166. Okay, next VGS equal to 1. VGS equal to 1 volt. Here approximately 0.9 means 1 volt only. VGS equal to 1 volt. Current ID is 146 microamps. For 1.5 VGS, I am getting 1.47, means approximately 1.5, and current is 125 microamps. Here you can see that current is decreasing here, 186 microamps, 166, 146, 125, as per graph. Next, VGG equal to 2 volts. VGG equal to 2 volts. We got VGS is 2 volts and current ID is 97, current ID is 97 microamps. For 2.5, VGG 2.5, we got VGS is 2.5 approximately and current is 71 microamps. For VGS, VGG 3 volts, VGS is 3 volts and current ID is 33 microamps. For 3.5, 10 microamps. 3.5 VGS, 10 microamps. For 4 volts, 4 volts, 0, and voltage is 4, VGS is 4, current ID is 0. Same as that, you have to, next is VDS equal to 3 volts. You have to do same VDS equal to 1 volt I have done. Now, next you have to do for VDS equal to 3 volts. By increasing VDD, first to minimize the VGS 0, you have to minimize the 0 volts VGS, and next, increase VDS equal to 3 volts. VDS equal to 3 volts. Okay, for VDS equal to 3 volts, same, we have to repeat, same as for VG, we have to increase VGG and we have to measure the values of VGS and ID. Same procedure. So, you will get maximum current is 407 here, 406 microamps, and it will, if you are increasing VGG, it will, ID will be decreases, same as VDS equal to 1 volt. Okay. Next, we have to go for drain characteristics. For drain characteristics, we have to fix the input voltage, that is VGS voltage. Here, input voltage is VGS voltage. In the transfer characteristics, we have fixed VDS voltage. In the drain characteristics, we are fixing the VGS voltage, input voltage. Okay. VGS voltage is same 0 volts and for minus 2 volts. Okay. So, first to minimize all the voltages 0 and first to fix the input voltage. Set the input voltage VGS is 0 volts. So, now it is 0 volts. For 0 volts, you have to increase the values VDD. By varying the VDD, you have to measure the values of ID and VDS for drain characteristics. For drain characteristics, we have to fix the input voltage, that is VGS 0 or 1, you have to take it any one, 0, minus 1, minus 2, like that. And you have to vary the VDD, by varying the VDD, you have to measure ID and VDS. Okay. For fixing the VGS equal to 0, so we have to, by varying VDD, we have to measure the 0 VDS and ID. So now VDD equal to 0. VDD equal to 0 volts, VDS is 0, ID also 0. This is for this experiment. For drain characteristics, this is the model graph or expected graph. For 0 volts, you are getting 0. If you are increasing VDD, it will increase some portion, and after that it will be approximately constant. Okay, like that you will get from this value, from this graph value. Okay, for VDD equal to 0.1, we have to increase step wise with 1 volt for out drain characteristics. For 1, we are getting for VDD equal to 1 volt, VDS is 0.9, current is 169 microamps. For 2 volts, VDD 2 volts, for 2 volts, 1.66 VDS, 1.66 VDS and 279 microamps for ID. This is for 2. For 2.3, next to for 3, 3 volts VDD, VDS is 2.61 and ID is 378 microamps. For 4 volts VDD, 3.55 VDS, ID is 437 microamps. For 5 volts VDD, 4.6 VDS and ID is 472 microamps. For 6 volts VDS, VDD, VDS is 5.5 and current ID is 490 microamps. For 7 volts VDS, VDD, for 7 volts VDD, VDS is 6.53 and current is 503 microamps. For 8 volts VDD, 7.52 VDS, 52N microamps ID. For 9 volts VDD, 8.35 VDS, 518 microamps ID. For 10 volts VDD, 9.58 VDS, 525 microamps ID. For 11 volts VDD, for 11 volts VDD, we got 10.57 VDS, 530 microamps ID. Here we are getting 503, 512, 518, 525, 530 is approximately constant. Expected graph also same, it is approximately constant. Okay. For next, we have to minimize the VDD up to 0, minimize the 0 volts. 0 volts, minimize the 0 volts. Next, fix the VGS is minus 2 volts. VGS is minus 2 volts. Minus 2. VGS is minus 2 volts. Next, same, we have to repeat the same procedure for VGS equal to 0, what we have done. Same as, next increase the VDD, like step is 1 volts, and we have to measure ID and VDS. For 0, you have got 0, 0. For 1 volt VDD, 0.85. And ID is 84 microamps. For 2 volts VDD, 1.84 VDS, 132 microamps. Same, you have to increase VDD as, and you will get approximately constant values. Okay. Next, go for graph. From this table, I have drawn the graph for transfer characteristics and drain characteristics. Here, this is for transfer characteristic graph. Here we got for VG, this graph is for VDS equal to 1 volt and this is VDS equal to 3 volts. Okay. From this, we can calculate transconductance. GM equal to delta ID by delta VGS at constant VDS. At constant VDS. From this graph, you can calculate it. Here, on the graph, you have to look at two points on the graph. Okay. From this graph, you have to draw a straight line on x-axis from two points, from this point and this point. Here, the difference between this one is delta VGS. Delta VGS is here you got 0.6 volts. And again, you have to draw a straight line on y-axis. Here to the from two points. Okay, from draw a line, straight line this one and this one. This difference is 37.5 microamp. That is, this is delta ID. Delta ID. Okay. From this, you have to calculate transconductance GM equal to here delta ID. Delta ID is 37.5 microamps and delta VGS is 0.6 volts. You can calculate it. From the drain characteristics, we have to calculate drain resistance. Drain resistance formula is delta VDS by delta ID at constant VGS. Okay. Okay. This is the graph for drain characteristics. VGS equal to minus 2 volts and this is VGS equal to 0 volts. VGS 0 minus 2. Okay. Same, you have to locate at two points on the graph here and draw a straight line on x-axis and y-axis from the both points. Okay. And you can measure the difference between two chain values. Here delta VDS, this is delta VDS from 10 minus 4 here. Value will be 10 minus 4 is 6 volts. Delta VDS is 6 volts. In the y-axis, ID is, difference between these two points is, delta ID is 30 microamps. Okay, I have written here GM equal to, RD equal to 6 volts by 30 microamps. So you have to calculate the value and amplification factor is RD into GM. You can calculate it.